Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Last week, Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka, who is the Wiper Party leader, indicated his willingness to work with the Deputy President, Dr. William Samoei Arap Ruto. This is what Kalonzo Musyoka said. If you hear Ruto looking for me, tell him I am available because Kenyans must consult. That statement by Kalonzo Musyoka was received differently, especially within Tanga Tanga movement. And the next day, when Tanga Tanga movements were in Naivasha and I think in Kiambu, most leaders actually appealed or requested Kalonzo Musyoka to work with the Deputy President, Dr. William Samoei Ruto. But the leadership, the UDA leadership from the Ukambani region, rejected the call by Kalonzo Musyoka to support the Deputy President, Dr. William Samoei Ruto. But none other than Johnson Muthama took it personal. And through a series of tweets, Muthama attacked Kalonzo Musyoka ruthlessly. So in this video today, I want us to look at why probably Johnson Muthama is not happy by the fact that Kalonzo Musyoka is now willing to work with the Deputy President, Dr. William Samoei Ruto. But before we do that, if you're watching this channel for the first time, please take a second or two and click the subscribe button so that next time we produce a video like this, YouTube will automatically notify you. And to the subscribers, I want to continue. Thank you guys for your continued support. And the request I'm making on this particular video, please just click the thumbs up and drop your comments for those who can. Now, let us get back to business. Who is Johnson Muthama? And who is Kalonzo Musyoka? How are they related, politically speaking? For a long time, personally, I thought that Johnson Muthama was the force behind the Wiper Party movement. And when Johnson Muthama left Wiper, most Kenyans predicted that Wiper Party was going to collapse. But the truth of the matter is that despite the fact that Johnson Muthama left, Wiper Party is still the same Wiper Party. So I can easily conclude that as much as Muthama was a close ally of Kalonzo Musyoka, as much as he was the sponsor, Wiper Party can survive beyond Johnson Muthama. And that's the fact. But why would Johnson Muthama get angry that Kalonzo Musyoka is willing to work with the Deputy President, Dr. William Samoei Ruto? Johnson Muthama is the UDA chairperson. As such, it was expected that he was going to embrace that statement by Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka. That did not happen. And by the way, I want to offer Johnson Muthama unsolicited advice before I get into the bones of this particular analysis. Should the Deputy President, Dr. William Samoei Ruto, decide to work with Kalonzo Musyoka, the person who will give way is none other than Johnson Muthama. There is nothing Johnson Muthama will do should the Deputy President decide to work with Kalonzo Musyoka. In fact, it's between Kalonzo and Ruto to agree to work together, but not Muthama determining. But let me not get into that. Why should Muthama get angry with Kalonzo Musyoka? Let me read for you the tweets which he posted, three of them. He's saying, Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka's tough choices are nothing but an old story of hyena which split into two, trying to make a choice on which two homestead it targeted meat was cooked. Kalonzo is torn between which side of bread is well buttered. He is looking for a job. Johnson Muthama supported Kalonzo Musyoka, I think, from 2007 up to now. If Kalonzo Musyoka has been looking for a job, probably got it as a vice president. And even Muthama supported Kalonzo Musyoka, knowing so well in 2013 that Kalonzo Musyoka was looking for a job. And he's continuing, this man has no stand. That's Muthama describing Kalonzo. This man has no stand. Neither does he know which direction to take the Kamba community, because he is always engulfed in self-aggrandizement at the expense of a uplifting the living standard of the people he purposed to lead. It's high time for Kamba to abandon and get into William Ruto's UDA party that has a guarantee to form the next government in 2022 and be assured of a piece of the national cake. Now that's Johnstone Ndonya Muthama describing Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka. Why would Muthama get angry that Kalonzo Musyoka is planning to work with the deputy president? Why is he not embracing the fact that should Kalonzo embrace Ruto, then Kamba Nation are likely to go to the direction he was telling or he was directing them to? In my view, Muthama is doing this because of four reasons. Number one, and this is my personal opinion, number one, Kalonzo Musyoka is just raising his profile and stakes before joining Raila Odinga. That's something that probably Johnson Muthama is well aware of, because this is a man who has worked very closely with Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka. So by claiming that he's going to join Ruto, what will happen is that Raila Odinga or maybe President Uhuru Kenyatta or even the deep state will try to reach out to him that don't go that direction. We need you on this side. So he will put his price. So to an extent that if Raila Odinga is not planning to have a running mate from some other region, let's say Mount Kenya region or someone else who is not Kalonzo, then Kalonzo has raised his stakes. So it means he can say that for me to remain with you guys, you must up the game. Otherwise, the other side is willing. And that is the game plan which Johnson Muthama is not allowing Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka to play. And in my own opinion, Kalonzo is playing smart politics by raising his profile. That about. Number two, it's about Kalonzo Ruto alliance. Should Kalonzo and Ruto form an alliance, what will be the consequences? The first consequence will be to render Johnson Muthama useless. Johnson Muthama is currently the UDA chairperson. He's the guy William Ruto consults whenever he wants to go to Kambani. If Wiper Party were to join or to start a form an alliance with William Ruto, it means Muthama will no longer be important. Ruto will channel his efforts, his resources, will be consulting none other than Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka. And politically, that's how it should be. But do you think Johnson Muthama will agree to be rendered irrelevant after working tirelessly for the deputy president? He can't. That's the first thing which will happen. Muthama will be rendered useless. Number two, the UDA party in Ukambani region is going to be rendered again useless. Wiper will take charge, because the truth of the matter is that Kalonzo Musyoka still has control of the Ukambani region. So the fact is, should he join Ruto, he might give a condition that let Ukambani region be Wiper zone. So where will the UDA party find solace in? And that's why Muthama is not very happy. So the fact of the matter is that Kalonzo Musyoka Ruto alliance will render Muthama irrelevant, will also render the United Democratic Alliance Party irrelevant. Number three, I personally think that Muthama is not yet over with this fight with Kalonzo Musyoka over the wife. Last year, there was a by-election in Machakos. Muthama opted to contest. Then Kalonzo Musyoka came from nowhere and pulled the wife and gave the wife the ticket. The wife went and campaigned against Johnson Muthama, and he defeated Muthama. And during that time, for those who follow politics, Muthama had made it very, very clear. Actually, Muthama had a candidate. He did not run. Muthama made it very clear that should the UDA candidate lose, he was going to exit politics. He was shocked that the UDA candidate was actually defeated by the wife. From that point up to now, I don't think Kalonzo and Muthama will be sitting on a table discussing anything meaningful. I don't think so. And that's why Muthama is telling Ruto that don't go for that man. That man has lost direction. He doesn't have any influence. And lastly, I think Johnson Muthama is scheming of becoming the next Ukambani kingpin. He wants to be the next leader from the Ukambani region. Muthama, in my view, is scheming. But can he succeed in that scheme? I don't think so. Now, this is how he's scheming. That he supports William Ruto. William Ruto becomes the president of the Republic of Kenya. Of course, he's going to run for the gubernatorial seat in Machakos, which is going to lose. After losing, and assuming Ruto becomes the president, Muthama is going to be appointed to a serious cabinet position. That appointment will put him at a higher level. And in that case, it would mean Kalonzo Musyoka is going to lose. If Kalonzo Musyoka is going to lose, I don't think Kalonzo Musyoka will rise. And therefore, Muthama will embark on a campaign of succeeding Kalonzo Musyoka in the Ukambani region. And that's the game plan. But the question is Kalonzo, is Johnson Muthama ready to take or to lead the Kamba nation into the next level of politics? Can he succeed where Kalonzo Musyoka has failed? I don't think so. So in my view, instead of being angry with Kalonzo Musyoka, William Ruto should advise, and this is my honest opinion, should advise Johnson Muthama to go slow on Kalonzo and work with Kalonzo. That Kalonzo Musyoka has the numbers. Kalonzo Musyoka might have lost that by-election due to the mismanagement of their party primaries. But the fact is, you cannot ignore Kalonzo Musyoka when it comes to Ukambani region. Kalonzo Musyoka might decide to run. The entire Kamba nation will rally behind him. And there's nothing you can do about that. I don't know what you think. Let me hear your thoughts. And in my next video, I want to look at the prediction by Mutahi Nguni on who will become the next president of the Republic of Kenya in 2022 and in 2027. Thank you guys, and may you have a good day. Bye-bye.